Good afternoon, everyone. We are the church, and we are gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Brothers and sisters, Jesus continues to reveal himself to us in all the readings we listen during the Mass. In the Gospel, the disciples were asking among themselves, who is the greatest? I truly believe that humility is one important virtue if we are really serious in following the Lord. We need to have humility in our hearts if we want to claim that we are Christians. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The wicked say, let us beset the just one, because he is obnoxious to us. He sets himself against our doings, reproaches us for transgressions of the law, and charges us with violations of our training. Let us see whether his words be true. Let us find out what will happen to him. For if the just one be the Son of God, God will defend him and deliver him from the hand of his foes. With revilement and torture, let us put the just one to the test, that we may have proof of his gentleness and try his patience. Let us condemn him to a shameful death, for according to his own words, God will take care of him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Beloved, where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder and every foul practice. But the wisdom from above is first of all pure, then peaceable, gentle, compliant, full of mercy and good fruits, without inconstancy or insincerity. And the fruit of righteousness is sown in peace for those who cultivate peace. Where do the wars and where do the conflicts among you come from? Is it not from your passions that make war within your members? You covet, but you do not possess. You kill and envy, but you cannot obtain. You fight and wage war. You do not possess because you do not ask. You ask, but do not receive, because you ask wrongly, to spend it on your passions. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus and his disciples left from there and began a journey through Galilee. But he did not wish anyone to know about it. He was teaching his disciples and telling them, "The Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise." But they did not understand the saying, and they were afraid to question him. They came to Capernaum, and once inside the house, he began to ask them, "What were you arguing about on the way?" But they remained silent. They had been discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. Then he sat down, called the 12, and said to them, "If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be last of all, and the servant of all." Taking a child, he placed it in their midst, and putting his arms around it, he said to them, "Whoever receives one child such as this in my name receives me, and whoever receives me receives not me, but the one who sent me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Let us continue learning more about the Eucharist by watching the video.
We gather today on the 25th Sunday in Ordinary Time. In the United States, in 2021, this Sunday has also been designated as Catechetical Sunday, an annual opportunity for us to reflect on the role that each person plays by virtue of baptism in handing on the faith and being a witness to the gospel. In the Diocese of San Diego, we are engaged in a process of Eucharistic renewal, an opportunity for all of us to come to a deeper and renewed understanding of the gift of the Eucharist in our lives as Catholic Christians. Last Sunday, we were reminded that the Eucharist is a direct, personal encounter with our Lord Jesus Christ. In the Eucharist, the body and blood, soul and divinity, really the whole of Christ, is truly, really, and substantially present and contained. Christ, God and man, makes himself entirely present to us. The Eucharist is the source and summit of the Christian life, which means that everything that has happened in our lives this week leads up to the celebration of the Eucharist, and everything that is to follow in our lives in the coming week will flow from our celebration of the Eucharist today. Our total existence as Catholic Christians is about this continuing dynamic of our lives, leading up to the Eucharist and then flowing from it, week in and week out. In this way, we become one with God and are joined together with the whole of the people of God on earth and in heaven. This week, I want to reflect with you upon what it means when we say that the Eucharist is the sacrificial memorial of Christ's passion, death, and resurrection by which we have redeemed. Essentially, when we share in the Eucharist, you and I share in the very sacrifice of Christ and the reality of the Paschal mystery. That term, Paschal mystery, sounds difficult to understand at first, maybe even a bit mysterious, but it's not hard to grasp. Simply stated, when we refer to the Paschal mystery, we refer to the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus. And through the gift of the Eucharist, God continues to invite us into a deeper relationship with him in Christ by the grace of the Holy Spirit, so that we can eventually say with St. Paul, it is no longer I who live, but it is Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. But even before Christ instituted the Eucharist at the Last Supper with his disciples, Jesus was teaching about the Paschal mystery. Did you hear it in today's gospel? He didn't explicitly use those words, Paschal mystery, but the mystery is there. Listen again. The disciples were on a journey through Galilee, and St. Mark writes, he was teaching his disciples and telling them, the Son of Man is to be handed over to men, and they will kill him. And 3 days after his death, the Son of Man will rise. The scripture scholar, Dr. John Bergsma, calls these words of Jesus striking and full of curious ironies. He goes on to say in his commentary on the gospel passage for today that for once, Jesus does not teach in parables or figures of speech, but blunt language. He describes how he is going to suffer and to die. And despite this, the disciples did not understand the saying. How ironic. How much plainer could Jesus be? But they just don't get it. And as in a classroom, no one wants to raise their hand and be exposed as the student who doesn't understand. So no one asks Jesus what he means. They all just nod in agreement and continue taking notes. What was important to the disciples was actually not important at all and was actually a distraction. Rather than trying to understand what Jesus was teaching them, Mark recalls that they were discussing among themselves on the way who was the greatest. So engrossed were they with their own greatness that they could not see the greatness of the Son of Man in their midst and hear the invitation to live one of the many ironies of gospel living. If anyone wishes to be first, he shall be the last of all and the servant of all. As with the disciples, so too with us. We are invited to live deeply with God in Christ Jesus. But in order to do so, we must hear the invitation, understand what is being asked of us, and set aside any distractions on the way that would keep us from this singular task to live the Paschal mystery, to allow the passion, death, and resurrection of Jesus, in short, the totality of Jesus, to live in me. What does it mean to say that the Mass is a sacrifice? We hear that term frequently, the sacrifice of the Mass. The Mass is a sacrifice in the sense that when it takes place, Jesus Christ, through the bishop or priest celebrating the Mass, makes present sacramentally his saving sacrificial death on the cross by which he redeemed us from our sins. The Eucharistic sacrifice is the memorial of Christ's redeeming death. The term memorial in this context is not simply a remembrance of past events. It is a making present, in a sacramental manner, the sacrifice of the cross of Christ and his victory. When the Church celebrates the Eucharist, the memorial of her Lord's death and resurrection, this central event of salvation becomes really present, and the work of our redemption is carried out. The Eucharistic sacrifice is offered to adore and to thank God, to pray for all our needs, and to gain pardon for our sins. It would be a mistake, then, to think that every celebration of the Eucharist is a new or different sacrifice. In reality, the sacrifice of the cross and the sacrifice of the Eucharist are one and the same sacrifice. The priest and the victim, Jesus Christ, are the same. Only the manner of offering is different. In a bloody manner on the cross, in an unbloody manner in the Eucharist. The sacrificial character of the Holy Eucharist is manifested in the very words of institution. We hear them at every Mass, don't we? This is my body, which is given for you, and this is the new covenant in my blood that will be shed for you. The sacrifice of the cross and the sacrifice of the Eucharist are one and the same sacrifice. In what way does the Church participate in the Eucharistic sacrifice? In the Eucharist, the sacrifice of Christ becomes also the sacrifice of the members of her body. The lives of the faithful, our lives, our praise, our suffering, our prayers, our work, are united to the life, praise, suffering, prayers, and work of Christ. In and through the Eucharist, we learn to offer our very selves, and so day by day be brought through the mediation of Christ into unity with God and with one another. You know, the theme of Catechetical Sunday this year is, "Say the word, and my soul shall be healed." These words are so familiar to us, aren't they? We say them right before receiving the body and blood of Christ at Mass. And as we hear the words of the bishop or priest, "Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb." We look at Jesus. We acknowledge our unworthiness, and realizing we are in need of a Savior and cannot save ourselves, try as hard as we might, we give our entire selves over to him by saying, "Say the word and my soul shall be healed." This is Jesus' deepest desire for us, that we be healed, saved, freed from our sins by the sacrifice of his body, indeed his entire being on the altar of the cross. To receive the Eucharist is to embrace with outstretched arms the Paschal mystery, to lose my life so that I might gain it, to be great by becoming the servant of all, setting aside all that would distract us on the way. In this way, then, Christ's victory and triumph over death is made present in the lives of those who participate in the Eucharist. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
Please stand as we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us offer our prayers in confidence, like little children who know that the Lord hears and answers them.
For the leaders of the church who speak in God's name, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For public officials, that they strive to serve the neediest first, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace in the Middle East and throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for those who are sick, that they turn to Jesus with joy and innocence of a child. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Remember those who have died, for our loved ones who have gone before us, and those who mourn the loss of someone dear to them. Remember especially Mary Alice Long, Nelson Rodriguez, Joel Matias Zia, Stella Reyes, Bridget Duenas, Anacleto Dominguez Navarro, Linda Boehm, Victoria Evans, and Brian Niles. Rest in peace, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our personal intentions. We pray to the Lord. God of mercy, you will judge us all in the last days. Hear the prayers of our hearts and grant them through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Thank you very much. God bless you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart may be accepted by you, O Lord, may sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Amen. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Please kneel. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death and tell your resurrection until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As one Eucharistic people called to love and serve God and one another, let us call on the Father through the very words Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you, peace be with you, peace be with you all.
Mercy on us, O Lord.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with the sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone. Thank you.